So today we'll start a new topic, that is cooperatives. Okay. Now cooperatives is a static subject. Cooperatives is a static subject from polity. Okay, it's a polity subject. It means in polity we will cover the constitutional aspect, but it is also a current affairs subject. It is also a dynamic subject. So here the topics will be from prelims point of view, mains point of view, and current affairs. Why? Because cooperatives is in current affair, because recently this year a bill was introduced, that is multi-state cooperatives bill. So that topic is multi-state. Two states are involved in a cooperative. So we'll first of all in this class we'll cover what are cooperatives, small definition of cooperatives and types of cooperatives. Then we'll cover the historical background, from when cooperatives started. So there we'll have a small component of modern history. Then we'll cover post-independence, the evolution of cooperatives. Then we'll cover the constitutional provisions, that is from Bear Act. I've written all the relevant provisions of Bear Act here. Okay. So the important provisions of constitutional provisions of cooperatives, Article ZH. Then we'll cover the Multi-State Cooperative Societies Bill. What are the provisions and what are the issues with the bill? That's it. So the whole cooperative topic is covered. Clear? Okay, so let's start. So what is cooperatives? So the word cooperatives has come from cooperation. What is cooperation? What is cooperation? Cooperation matlab kya hota hai? You cooperate, you cannot cooperate yourself, right? Khud ko cooperate thodi karoge. You can't cooperate yourself. So 2 to 3 people are required. More than one. Cooperation hota hai. So cooperatives are autonomous associations of persons united voluntarily. So this is the keyword, voluntarily. Theek hai? Voluntary means what? Own will. Some persons come together. That group is a cooperative society. Now, what is the objective? It can be anything. It can be related to banking. It can be related to agriculture. It can be related to anything. So, it has common economic, social, and cultural needs or objectives. It can be anything. Give me an example of a cooperative, very famous example. Amul. Amul is a very famous example of a cooperative. Okay. So there are many types, like farmers cooperative societies, marketing cooperative societies, producer cooperative societies, credit cooperative societies, they give credit. Thanks. Banking, anything. Group of persons come together and they are like-minded people. Remember, they are like-minded people. And their objective should be the same. Okay, fine. Next. So, the largest cooperative society, this is the largest cooperative society, that is IFCO, Indian Farmers Fertilizer Cooperative. Amul is not the largest. Amul is famous. It is the largest. It is the largest fertilizer company also. Okay. It's basically a society. It came in 1967. Indian Farmers Fertilizer Cooperative. For state exams, they may ask. Okay, fine. Now we'll cover the origin or the evolution of cooperatives. From where it started, everything started. See, this term cooperative is a British phenomenon. It came from the British era. So the first act came in Cooperative Societies Act of 1904 when Lord Curzon was there. He was the Governor General, okay? 1904. See, small rules were there before 1904 also. But what I'm trying to say here is the full-fledged act, okay? It came in 1904, that is Cooperative Societies Act of 1904, pre-independence. Now, today, we know that cooperatives is a state subject. State means it will be, the laws regarding cooperative societies will be made by the state government. We'll come to that. But if someone asks you from where, what is the origin of it? The origin is 1919 Act of Government of India Act 1919, which we cover in modern history. 1858 Act, 1919 Act, 1935 Act. So, in 1919 Act, this cooperative was made a part of the provincial subject. That is nothing but in today's time it is called as state subject. Clear? Now, same year, in same time, the first cooperative land mortgage banks was also established in Punjab. Just a small information. The first land mortgage banks, cooperative, it was established in Punjab and in other states also. But first it was established in Punjab. Clear? Just make short notes. Okay, next. So here you just need to know, pre-independence, this is the law. But remember, in prelims I may ask you, this is the first law, okay, but the cooperatives being a part of provincial subject, it came in 1919 Act, not here. Okay, clear? Okay, fine, next. Now coming to post-independence. Post-independence, some information regarding post-independence, like what happened, the evolution of cooperatives after independence. See, we know there were 5-year plans, right? It's not there today because Niti Aayog has replaced the planning commission. Before it was planning commission. Planning commission was doing 5-year plans. So this is an economic topic. Okay, 5-year plans. And this cooperatives was an integral part of the first 5-year plan. 1951 to 1955, the first 5-year plan. 51 to 56. So this was also part, but see, there was no law. At that point of time, there was no law. It was simply made a part of the first 5-year plan. That does not mean ki law came. Law was not there. In 1950, the constitution came. Even in the original constitution, cooperatives were not there. They came in the 97th Constitutional Amendment Act. 2011. In 2011, the cooperatives were given a constitutional status. Very recent, 10-11 years back. 1950, in the original constitution, cooperatives were not given any kind of provision. Fine. Next, what happened? There is something called NCDC Act, that is National Cooperative Development Corporation Act. National Cooperative Development Corporation Act. From this act, if 1962, a statutory body was created. That body name is National Cooperative Development Corporation. So now if you see carefully, from 1962, it got a legal status. Yes or no? Legal status it got, 1962. Constitutional status, till now 1962, it was not there. Okay. Now what is the name? NCDC, National Cooperative Development Corporation. It is a government body, it's a statutory body which will take care of the cooperatives. Clear? Of all the cooperatives formed. Now, finally, in the 97th Constitutional Amendment Act, the cooperatives were given a constitutional status. They were given a constitutional status. Now, in this amendment act, three things were added to the constitution. Three things were added to the constitution. What are the three things? First thing is Article 19. In Article 19, we have covered Article 19, fundamental rights. Okay. One provision was added, ki right to establish cooperatives is a fundamental right. Right to establish cooperatives is a fundamental right. 2 to 3 people, it is your fundamental right. You can establish cooperatives, nobody can stop you. Now I twist the sentence. Right to become member of a cooperative society, is it a fundamental right? No. Right, you do not have fundamental right to become a member. No, there are provisions to become a member. We'll come to that. But to establish a cooperative society, it became a fundamental right in 2011 through the 97th Constitutional Amendment Act. Second point is, they also added one point in the DPSP. Article 43 clause 2, ki states should promote cooperative societies, or the say states should endeavor, E-N-D-E-A-V-O-U-R, endeavor means they'll try to promote cooperative societies. This is the second thing added. It was not in the original constitution. Okay, so 1 point from DPSP, 1 point from fundamental rights were added. Third point is, a full part was added. A full part was added, that is part 9B. Now in state exams, they may ask you the part number. Or in banking level exams, they may ask you the part number. Which of the following part was added in the 97th Constitutional Amendment Act? These are not UPSC level questions. These are state level or banking level questions. So 9B was added, that is full article 243 ZH to ZT, which is mentioned in our Bayer Act, which we will cover right now. This full part was added. This is nothing but just after municipalities. Panchayats, municipalities over, then 243 is municipality, right? ZH started this in 2011. Clear? So these three things were added in 2011 Constitutional Amendment 97. So from 2011, cooperatives have a legal backing in NCDC 1962. Now they have a constitutional backing also. Now the problem is, in prelims they will ask, cooperatives only have a constitutional backing and not a legal backing, because everyone knows 97th amendment mein constitutional status was given, but in 1962 long back, legal backing was also there. So that is the reason why when you are covering a topic, you should cover from the legal point of view, constitutional point of view, and also judicial point of view. Now we are not yet into the judicial point of view. Now the judicial point of view, it will be a part of current affairs, which is last year 2021 June or July mein Supreme Court gave a verdict. We'll come to that slowly. Yahan tak samajh mein aa gaya sabko? Clear? Okay, next. Now coming to the constitutional provisions. Now constitutional provisions, usually we do it from Bayer Act. These are all Bayer Act. I have written in a very easy manner. When you cover, see the Bayer Act, same thing, but I have written in an easy manner. So now we'll cover the important provisions from prelims perspective, 243 ZS to ZT. No need to cover everything. Okay? For example, 243 ZH, it says cooperative societies, states will do. Simple, states will make laws. Now, next article is this. Members of board of directors and terms of office. Now, cooperative society is done. Okay? Now, who will be the members? What will be their term? Everything are mentioned in constitution, not in NCDC Act of 1962. Be clear. Now, so there will be a board of directors. Board, okay? In this board, the number of directors, it can be 1, it can be 5, it can be 10, we don't know. Now the number of directors will be provided by the state legislature, clearly mentioned in this article. Article number is not required. State legislature. But maximum number, in the article it is mentioned, provided that the maximum number will be 21. Maximum number is 21. It can be 15, it can be 10, it can be 12, depending on the state legislature. Because cooperative societies is in state subject. It is a state subject. It is not a central subject. Okay, I am not talking about multi-state. I am only talking about सिंगल स्टेट कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज, देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन सिंगल स्टेट एंड मल्टी स्टेट, विल कम टू दैट वन बाय वन. क्लियर? नाउ एवरी कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी विल हैव अ बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स, राइट? इन दैट बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स वन सीट, टोटल 21 सीट्स, number will be decided by state government or state legislature. See, when I'm writing legislature, means it is through law. When there is state government, it can be through cabinet, executive. Clear? By law they will pass. Every state will have their own laws, right? Now one seat will be reserved from the board of directors, one seat will be reserved for SC or ST, not and. SC or ST, okay, you can write or. Two seats will be reserved for women. Now, usually we have covered panchayats, we have covered municipalities, there you have seen provisions of women, one third representation, SC, ST, and some provisions for OBC also. Here, there is no provisions about OBC. Now do not fall in the trap question. They may put, as per the constitution, the seats will be reserved for, there are provisions for reservation of SC, ST, women and OBC, they will put. So flow mein aap sahi kar dete ho, pata nahi chalta hai. So here you have to write, OBC ke liye nahi hai. For OBC there is no provisions of reservation. Clear? Now board's elected members and office bearers will serve 5 years from the date of their appointment. So term is, so this terms of office is 5 years, simple. Clear? Next. Now coming to election, election will be also there. Now the election is also, now the provisions of election is also mentioned in constitution. Here about the board members, election must be held before the expiration of the term. Term khatam ho jayega, so election must be held before the expiration of the term. Now provisions of the elections, how the elections will be, everything will be, it means, for example, there is a election commission which will conduct the elections, preparation of electoral rolls, everything. Similarly here the state legislature will make a law and will assign to such body which will produce the electoral rolls and will also conduct the elections. That is, it will have the superintendence, it will have the guidance, it will have the control, everything. You can't say state legislature will have the control. How can legislature have a control? Legislature kya hota hai? Wahan pe ek hall hota hai, log baithte hai wahan pe. So legislature will pass a law, it will give this power to such body. Now which body, we don't know. It depends on the state legislature. It will give the power to do all this. Clear? Fine. Production of electoral rolls, superintendence, guidance, control, everything related to elections. Next. Now coming to another provision, that is accounts of cooperative societies. The society will have an account, right? So when the word account comes, audit comes. So now they may ask, the audit of cooperative societies are done by CAG. They may ask you. Now you may think, yes, CAG does state government accounts, CAG also does central government accounts. Now you may think cooperatives comes under state governments. So we will put equation. Equation 1, equation 2. From 1 and 2, it is clear that CAG will also do the audits of cooperative societies, which is wrong. You should not put mathematical equations in UPSC GS. Okay? Karte na hum equation karte na school mein. In school times, we used to, when you do not know answer, khas karke jo mathematics question given to prove, answer chhod do, answer pata nahi hai, 2 mark mil jayega. Kuch kuch bachche hote hain jo given hai na, 2 page likhte hain, pura given ko explain kar dete hain, aur wo cheez jisne question banaya tha usko bhi malum nahi. वो जब देखता है, अरे यार इतना अच्छा क्वेश्चन मैंने खुद बनाया, मेरे को भी मालूम नहीं था, बिकॉज द स्टूडेंट हैज गिवन एक्सप्लेन द क्वेश्चन विदाउट आंसर. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ अकाउंट्स, नाउ द प्रोविजंस रिगार्डिंग द अकाउंट्स ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज विल बी गिवन बाय ऑल द प्रोविजंस, ऑल डिफरेंट प्रोविजन, डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स विल बी गिवन बाय स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर. नाउ ऑडिट एटलीस्ट once a year hoga, it is mentioned. Now audit will happen once a year, it is mentioned in this article. Now provisions like how to do, what to do, who will do, all these things are will be done by the state legislature. State legislature assign karega kisi ko, it can be anyone. Okay, now every cooperative society must have its finances audited. Jitna bhi cooperative societies hain, it is mandatory they need to get their finances audited within 6 months of the financial year end by an auditor auditing firm. By an auditor auditing firms hota hai na, companies hota hai, auditing companies hota hai, appointed by cooperative societies general body. Clear? Just you need to remember ki CAG do not have a role explicitly to audit cooperative societies. Problem is the word audit. UPSC aspirant jahan pe audit word dekh lete hain, CAG ko bula dete hain, audit CAG aa jao. CAG bolega pehle padhai to kar lo, mera nahi hai wahan pe kaam. Okay, CAG bolega pehle revise karo bar bar. मुझे हर जगह मत बुलाओ जहाँ पे मेरा एक्सेस नहीं है. ठीक है, ओके. नेक्स्ट, नाउ रिटर्न्स. दिस इज ऑल्सो ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजन, आर्टिकल इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू रिमेंबर. नाउ एवरी कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी मस्ट फाइल, मस्ट इट मीन्स, so it is mandatory for every society, cooperative society, to file returns, okay, to the body designated by the again state government. Now how they will trap you in a prelims question ki every cooperative society will file, it is mandatory for every cooperative society to file returns to the income tax department. लिखा है क्या यहाँ पे income tax department? Problem क्या है? You file to whom? Income tax. But you are not a cooperative society ना. You may think कि I am filing, so cooperative society भी file करेगा. Again, no need to overthink. If you do not know, explicitly leave the question. ठीक है, within 6 months after the end of the each financial year, financial year का after, within 6 months you have to, the cooperative society has to file returns to that body which is mentioned by the state government. Clear? Now here it is state government, it is not state legislature. So government can put anybody or can provide anybody through rule, through cabinet or through executive. Clear? Understood? Next, offenses and penalties. If you are not following the rules, if you are not like you are against some rules, so penalty रहेगा ना, या ऐसे ही मतलब छोड़ देंगे, unless and until you are very powerful. तो यहाँ पे भी the offenses and rules, who will give? State legislature has the authority to enact laws. Now no need to go to the law and see कितना offense है, 6 साल का है, 1 साल का है, 10 साल का है, ये सब मत पढ़ाई करो, नहीं आता है वो. Every state will have their own thing. So who will make these laws? State legislature. Clear? Now the question comes. Now this is also a prelims point. Now all these provisions which is mentioned in Constitution regarding 97th amendment or societies, cooperative societies, are they applicable to union territories? They are applicable. All these things are applicable to union. These rules also apply to union territories, but there is a exception. There is an exception. Now when union territory word comes, there will be precedent, because it is union. It is union territory. Territory is controlled by the union. So here the precedent may indicate some changes. The precedent may indicate some changes. Now this point is very important for prelims. The precedent may say ki from today, through a notification, remember, through a notification, ki from today these provisions of cooperative societies mentioned in the Constitution will not apply to this union territory or a part of this union territory or a part of this union territory. Simple. Now how they'll frame the question? The precedent, not a statement, in the exam they'll ask the provisions of cooperative societies mentioned in the Constitution are applicable to union territories and cannot be changed. These are the way they will frame the questions. It shall be applicable to union territories and cannot be changed. Why cannot be changed? It can be changed. How? Precedent may indicate through in a notification that the provisions do not apply to union territory. Just two lines you have to remember. So you have to be very prelim specific. It has nothing to do with mains. In particular to this point, this provision has nothing to do with mains. Next. Now comes the important part, which is in news. That is multi-state cooperatives. Now this is in news. We'll cover why it is in news. It is in news. This year it is in news. Now, we have provisions of multi-state cooperatives in Constitution also. This is one of the article. We are going through the articles now. We are going through the Bare Act now. Okay, I have written the Bare Act here. So in one article, this particular sentence is mentioned. It is mentioned that the provisions of this whole part, that is 9B, is applicable to multi-state cooperatives. What is mentioned? All these constitutional provisions shall also apply to the multi-state cooperatives with modifications that any reference to the state legislature, state act or state government shall be understood as a reference to parliament, central act or central government respectively. Now what I'm trying to say here is, now be careful. What I'm trying to say here is, multi-state cooperatives has a provision, all provisions like the election of board of directors, tenure, accounts, all are applicable to multi-state cooperatives. Okay? Now, what is a multi-state cooperatives? A cooperative society which has operation in more than one state. A cooperative society which has its operations in more than one state. मतलब कुछ काम उनका, ऑपरेशन जो चलता है उनका, दूसरे स्टेट में भी है. सो इट बिकम्स अ मल्टी स्टेट एंड द बोर्ड ऑफ मेंबर्स विल बी फ्रॉम बोथ स्टेट्स. or a three-state or a four-state, depending. Now we'll cover multi-state cooperatives. Now, Bare Act is over. The constitutional provisions of cooperative societies is over. All those provisions also apply to union territories. All those provisions also apply to multi-state cooperatives. Now, what is multi-state cooperatives? Now, multi-state cooperatives are in news. Why it is in news? Because of this. It is in news because recently in 2022, the government brought a bill that is Multi-State Cooperative Societies Bill of 2022. So here, we need to know the provisions of this bill. What are the issues with this bill? So that will be a mains question. But the provisions of this bill will be a prelims question. Okay, now you may have something in your mind ki how come the central government are passing a bill, because state cooperatives are a state subject. Yes or no? It is a state subject. Now this is a doubt which you have, you may be facing now. Okay, now listen, the original act regarding multi-state cooperatives was in 1984. Now in 1984, was there a constitutional provision of cooperatives? No. The constitutional provision of cooperatives came in 2011. Central government had already passed a law regarding multi-state, only multi-state, in 1984. They amended that law, which is the now the original law, that is 2002 law. Multi-State Cooperative Societies Act of 2002, MSCS's Multi-State Cooperative Society. Why? To consolidate different laws, different alag-alag laws to a single law. Okay? Because anyways, multi-state cooperatives deals with 2 to 3 states, right? Understood? Now, what this bill is doing, it is amending 2002 bill. All these things happened in before 2011. Yes or no? Now it is amending this 2002 Act. This MSCS Act 2002 deals with multi-state cooperatives. Now after 2002, 2011 came. In 2011, the whole ZH to ZT articles were added. Part 13B was added. There, all provisions are mostly related to single cooperative society. One provision was there, it will be related to all, it will apply to multi-state cooperatives. Okay, so there is clarity. Now, dekho kya hota hai. First of all, we will cover this bill, then we will cover the judicial judgment of 2021, what it said. Now, what? First of all, what are multi-state cooperatives? As I told, operations in one or more states. Operations in one more than one state. Now, for one example, there is a farmer producer organization. It is also a cooperative society. All the farmer producers will come and make a association. So an FPO which procures food grains from farmers from multiple states, it become a multi-state, right? It is procuring grains from farmers from multiple states. So if you are procuring from multiple states, so it becomes a multi-state. It means simple, the operations will be in more than one state. Not only FPO, it can be anyone where operations are more than one state. Okay, now such multi-state cooperative societies are registered under the 2002 Act. Parliament has enacted this law before 2011 about multi-state, not about single state. Multi-state ke baare mein Parliament ne law already enact kar diya tha 2002 mein. And they said ki these kind of multi-state will be registered under this act, and their regulation lies with the central register. मतलब सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के अंडर में रहेगा. क्लियर मल्टी स्टेट के बारे में. ओके नाउ दिस इज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट फ्लॉ बिकॉज एनीवेज यू आर एनक्रोचिंग इनटू टू और मोर स्टेट्स. यस और नो. ऑन वन साइड यू आर सेइंग एनीवेज मल्टी स्टेट हो या सिंगल स्टेट हो, आफ्टर ऑल इट इज अ कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी एंड कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज आर एक्सक्लूसिव ज्यूरिसडिक्शन ऑफ स्टेट्स आफ्टर 2011. After 2011, if you see this act, you may think it is an encroachment. The central government is interfering. Yes or no? So it becomes one of the criticism point. Mains mein ek point mil gaya. Clear? Now, the board of directors are from all states where the operation is happening. Obviously, the board of directors will be also from all states, right, where the operation is happening, because it is multi-state. But in single state cooperative society, the board of directors will be from that state, depending on the state government. The board of directors are from all states from where the operation is. Now, the largest or the highest multi-state cooperatives in which part of India? Now, these kind of questions they'll ask you in normal exams, CDPO exams, or all those banking level exams, that multi-state cooperative sabse jyada kaun se state mein hai? Maharashtra mein, around 1500. Clear? Even in, they can ask you in UPC also, in a statement format. They'll not ask in a single format, they'll ask in a statement format. Tamil Nadu has the number of highest number of multi-state cooperatives. It will be wrong statement. ठीक है. नेक्स्ट नाउ कमिंग टू द करंट अफेयर्स. कमिंग टू द अमेंडमेंट बिल ऑफ 2022. इट इज अमेंडिंग 2002 एक्ट. ओके सो 22 में एक बिल आया है विच इज ए रीसेंट करंट अफेयर्स. सो दीज आर ऑल पार्ट ऑफ करंट अफेयर्स गवर्नेंस टॉपिक. You will not find in book. You have to cover it through current affairs. ठीक है. Now these are the key amendments. I have written in very short. The key amendments are, the government is saying, government means who? The central government. The central government is saying कि there should be a cooperative election authority. बिकॉज टू स्टेट्स आर इन्वॉल्व तो एक इलेक्शन अथॉरिटी होना चाहिए. कोऑपरेटिव इलेक्शन अथॉरिटी होना चाहिए. जब इलेक्शन होगा दैट कोऑपरेटिव इलेक्शन अथॉरिटी विल डिसाइड. नंबर वन. सो व्हेन यू प्रिपेयर फॉर मेंस जस्ट रिमेंबर लाइक दिस एंड फ्रेम योर ओन सेंटेंस इन द एग्जाम. सेकेंड इज अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ ए कोऑपरेटिव इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफिसर. Information, because more than one state is involved, so information sharing has to be done. Okay, so cooperative information officer ek rahega. Aur kya rahega? One or more cooperative ombudsman. Ombudsman means what? Checking. Suppose it will, you have any complaint, you can go to ombudsman. It means it will handle your complaints or grievances. It will handle your complaints or grievances. Now one or two. We have a RBI ombudsman. Any banking services you are not, you want to complain, you can go to RBI ombudsman. Similarly, we have a cooperative ombudsman. Now cooperative ombudsman is not there. It's a part of this amendment bill. Clear? Now another thing also they are saying ki let's bring a cooperative rehabilitation and development fund. Very important. All are prelim subjects. Cooperative rehabilitation and fund. Matlab kya hai? Now tell me. Now see, you have to, when you write in mains, you have to also write what it does. You simply can't write one on word. What it does? Cooperative rehabilitation and development fund. From the word only you can guess what is it. Batao. Rehabilitation means what? मतलब द कोऑपरेटिव्स इज इन स्ट्रेस नाउ, वी हैव टू रिहैबिलिटेट इट, क्राइसिस में है, फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस में है या कोई भी क्राइसिस में, वी हैव टू रिहैबिलिटेट इट, एंड टू रिहैबिलिटेट एनीथिंग यू नीड मनी। फ्री में कौन रिहैबिलिटेट करता है? फ्री में होता है क्या कोई? नहीं होता है, तो पैसा चाहिए। तो रिहैबिलिटेट द कोऑपरेटिव एंड डेवलप दिस कोऑपरेटिव, फॉर दैट वी नीड ए फंड। इट्स अ गुड थिंग, नाउ इट इज अ गुड थिंग, पॉजिटिव्स में यू कैन राइट। नाउ रिगार्डिंग रिहैबिलिटेशन इश्यूज, डू वी हैव एनीथिंग इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन? नो, वी डोंट हैव एनी लॉ और एनी इवन लॉ और एनी कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजन रिगार्डिंग रिहैबिलिटेशन, सो इट्स अ गुड थिंग, सो यू हैव टू राइट देयर because you do not have any rehabilitation provision in constitution, so it's a progressive step. Now to write this, you need to know ki there is nothing mentioned in constitution, and to know ki there is nothing mentioned in the constitution, you need to read Bayer Act. Cover ho gaya pura connectivity. Normal book padh ke you can't know, you may think ha shayad hoga, humne to padha nahi hai, theek hai। One more point, merger of any cooperative society into another existing cooperative society. Now this is good or bad? Good or bad? Batao. Huh?
Any chances of any cooperative society?
Individual, more central, grasping.
See, two things. इट इज अ बोथ, जैसे हम देर इज अ टॉपिक इन इकोनॉमी मर्जर ऑफ बैंक्स, इट्स अ बोथ टू वे थिंग। मर्ज इफ यू आर डूइंग इट, सो इट विल बी अंडर वन कंट्रोल ऑफ अनदर पावरफुल और हेल्दी कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी, सो इट्स अ गुड थिंग। द नेगेटिव थिंग इज मर्जिंग मीन्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देर इज नो प्रोविजन इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन रिगार्डिंग मर्जिंग। सी, this fund is a good thing, any fund is a good thing whether it is mentioned or not, but there is no explicit provision about merging, number one, in constitution. Number two, merging you are doing, you are indirectly, the central government is interfering. Now the state cooperative, it is under state's jurisdiction, it is under state jurisdiction. There is another state in outside this state, there is another healthy cooperative that is under that state jurisdiction explicitly. Now parliament is coming inside this and telling ki from tomorrow you will merge with this. Is it good? Fir you have to go via constitutional. Anyway it is independent, right? Multi-state to hai, lekin hai to ek state ke andar na. So this is the way you have to write in critical analysis. So merger of any cooperative society into an existing society. Okay? So these are the five important key amendments. Other amendments are there, but you will not have scope to write more. So these key amendments you can write. Positive points you can write here. This is a good thing, this is a good thing, this is a good thing, this is a good thing. But this is a problem. Now coming to the key issues. Issues with the bill. As I told you now, the issues with the bill. First point is center's encroachment. Center is indirectly interfering, right? Indirectly interfering. Encroachment is nothing but that. You are interfering. Yes or no? Points ready karo. Exam mein normal likhoge. कीवर्ड्स रेडी, ये कीवर्ड्स से ही प्रिपरेशन होती है। नाउ मर्जिंग प्रोविजन इज ऑल्सो नॉट मेंशन इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। मर्जिंग प्रोविजन, एनी प्रोविजन मेंशन इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन द बेयर एक्ट? नो, देर इज नो प्रोविजन मेंशन इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। थर्ड पॉइंट इज द सेंट्रल रजिस्ट्रार कैन ओनली अलाउ इंस्पेक्शन ऑफ सोसाइटीज अंडर स्पेशल कंडीशंस। नाउ अगेन यू आर गिविंग पावर टू द सेंट्रल रजिस्ट्रार, दैट इज सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, राइट? सो मेनली द इश्यूज लाइज विद सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट्स एनक्रोचमेंट। नाउ वन मोर पॉइंट यू कैन राइट, ऑन वन साइड यू आर सेइंग द कोऑपरेटिव्स आर अंडर स्टेट लिस्ट, okay? And multi-state cooperatives, because it deals with one and more state, center is interfering. So it creates an ambiguity, right? It creates an ambiguity. Okay? Next. Now, in a mains answer, when you give these kind of dimensions, you have to also write the judicial pronouncement. Judiciary has also said something. That you can put in your way forward also. Now, what judiciary has said, we will come to know now. It is also recent current affairs. Now, this is the Supreme Court judgment in 2021 June or July last year. Now, this is the Supreme Court judgment in 2021. Now, in July 2021, the Supreme Court struck down certain provisions of the 97th Amendment Act. Okay. Now, what Supreme Court said clearly? It said ki Article 243 ZH to Article 243 ZT, which we now covered, has significantly affected or limited state's exclusive power. On one side, we are giving state exclusive power, and on the other side, multi-state may, because see, multi-state, 1500 multi-states are there in only Maharashtra. Okay, now it becomes difficult, right? So we need to have a clear-cut law. Supreme Court said, 97th Constitutional Amendment Act, very important point, it was passed without getting them ratified by state legislatures. Now, there is a chapter called amendment in polity. How many types of amendment are there?
Three types
of amendment are there. One is simple. One is special majority. And one is special plus half of the state's consent or ratification. Now, this third part is mostly related to federal, where states are also a part of that particular issue. So, states ka ratification bhi to chahiye. If states are a shareholder, federal means what? Center state. Now, in this particular 97 Amendment Act, it was not passed through this. Ab state bhi to involved hai. If states are involved, technically, it is a federal issue. So, technically, you should pass through the third part. Special majority plus one third. As per our constitutional provisions, Article 368, that is amendment. But what the center has done, it did not pass this 97 Amendment Act through this. States ka consent nahi liya tha. That is what Supreme Court told now. That is what Supreme Court told now. Supreme Court also said, but regarding the multi-state cooperatives, Supreme Court upheld the validity. Supreme Court said, yes, the validity of multi-state cooperative society is correct, and the legislative power would be of the union. Ab dekho, humne criticism bhi likha, but we have to also follow Supreme Court guidelines. But having said this, the recent judgment of 2011, where the Supreme Court has upheld the validity of multi-state cooperatives and said the legislative power of multi-state cooperatives will lie with the union government. Understood? So this is the total topic of cooperatives, which you covered in less than 1 hour. I wrote this in 15 minutes when your environment chal raha tha. So this is how you have to cover topic wise preparation. Aise hi padhna hai, revise karna hai, aur analysis, two way analysis.